Okay, Beta. Now let's start the topic today. So yesterday we have seen the continuation of that we are going to see. So all are ready? Okay, Beta. Today we are going to see the psychiatric emergencies. This is the continuation of Beta. Beta, please unmute your microphone. In the screen there will be a phone option. Please unmute Karo. Okay, yesterday we have seen about suicide. The next topic is violent and aggressive behavior. The next topic is violent and aggressive behavior. Okay, Beta. So, usually, psychiatric patient will not have calm mind. That's why they are having more anger and aggressiveness. And patient who is having abnormal in the mind will think irrational. Irrational thinking will be jada hai. As a result of this, they don't cooperate with others. They will be uncooperative. They are not friendly in nature. They will be uncooperative with everyone. They don't follow the rules and regulation. They also have delusional behavior. You know the delusional, grandiosity delusional, paranoid delusion. So this kind of delusion also make them to behave in an aggressive way. And they involve in assaultative behavior.
Yes.
What do you mean by assaultative behavior? Assaultative behavior is kind of behavior which involve in violent activities like either physical assault or sexual assault or verbal assault, okay, hurting others. Okay, Beta. So this is introduction about violent and aggressive behavior. Now let us see the next thing about the violent and aggressive behavior. So there are some conditions which is associated with violent behavior, like acute intoxication. When you take alcohol large amount, so during that time intoxication occurs. So during the intoxication episode, we will behave violent and aggressive with others. Second one is acute psychosis. For example, simple schizophrenia. So during the time of acute psychotic episode, they don't cooperate with others in the environment. So they try to show violent and aggressive behavior, particularly those who have mania in the emotional behavior. So they all will do such things. Okay. Next thing, like patient who is having paranoid personality disorder. They have suspicious thoughts. They behave violent and aggressive. The next one is that narcissistic personality disorder. So like Hitler, narcissistic personality disorder. The example is Hitler. So Hitler, how he behaved? He always kill others. He always show no mercy for other people. Personality people also show more aggression and violent activity. Borderline personality disorder. Some people cannot judge. They are in which personality. So they are in the borderline. Sometimes they will be in the right side. Sometimes they will be in the
left side. They cannot judge their standard personality.
Beta, please unmute your mic. Unmute your... Sorry, please mute. Please mute. Don't unmute. Someone's voice is coming. Please mute. Okay, so these are the common
I think Sahil Daya, voice disturb karte beta.
Please unmute. Unmute your mic, beta. Others also suffering. Okay, now let us see the other things related to violent and aggressive behavior, signs and symptoms. So basically how we can identify the person is having a violent behavior. When you see a person, they clench the fist, they clench the jaw. So when they clench the fist and jaw, we know they are getting anger and they are going to become aggressive. And sometimes they will be slamming the door or near the some object they will be hitting. so that we can come to proper understanding, he is going to become assertive. Sometimes they hitting the palms like that they will do, or they will hit the fist. So such symptoms which the person exhibits, so they are violent and aggressive. Sometimes easily startled. Okay, so easily they get distracted, startled. So like this, suddenly they do like that. That also shows they are having violent behavior. Okay. Now next we will see about aggressive behavior. So we have seen the violent behavior. Next we are going to see aggressive behavior. Aggressive behavior is very common. In our childhood days, we fight with our siblings, neighbor children. Even after taking alcohol, we beat others, we show the aggression. Our emotional feeling, we cannot divert properly. We cannot show the emotional feelings in a proper way. Such people go for negative way of demonstrating the emotional feelings. That is called aggressive behavior. So when you learn aggressive behavior, you want to learn two things. One is anger and another one is aggression. You want to learn the two things. One is anger and aggression. Anger kya hota hai? Anger is defined as a strong, uncomfortable emotional response. It is a uncomfortable emotional response which is provocating that is unwanted. That is some emotional feelings which is coming in us. Unwanted feelings, which is provocating, which is stimulating, and incongruent with one's values, beliefs, or rights. For example, you are educated. You know how to control your emotion. But you know you are coming from a high-five family. You are coming from good background. But you are showing a different emotional outlet of expression. That is called as anger. This anger will be damaging self as well as others. Next one is aggression. Aggression is a behavior. Anger is an emotional feeling. Aggression is a behavior which comes because of outburst of anger. Aggression refers to behavior that is intended to cause harm or panic. So what do you mean by panic? Panic is the excessive amount of anxiety. That is called panic. So understand, anger is an emotional feeling. Aggression is the behavior which we show because of outburst of anger. Now, this aggression is two types. One is physical aggression, another one is verbal aggression. So you know physical aggression, you beat others, you damage others' property. What is verbal aggression? Gande gande baat karte. Okay, kisi ke upar you scold very badly. Okay, that is verbal aggressive behavior. Mostly in village, we can see the local people fight each other. Okay, they use abusive languages. When I gone to psychiatric posting, I seen that this female psychiatric patients commonly involved in verbal aggression activity. Male psychiatric patient involved in physical aggression activity. Okay, keep in mind. Now, next thing is, what are the types of aggression? So basically, we are having different types of aggression. First one is instrumental aggression. Next one is hostile aggression. Third one is relational aggression. What is instrumental aggression? You are showing your aggressive behavior for some object. For example, your friend is having some costly iPhone or costly some device. You want to steal that property. Or you are jealous about someone's property. So your intention is towards the object. You are showing your aggressiveness towards that particular object. That is called instrumental aggression. That is called instrumental aggression. Next one is hostile aggression. Hostile. Hostile means enmity. You don't like any one person. For example, you don't like your roommate. Your roommate is fighting with you. So you are showing your aggression towards that person in the form of enmity. How you will show? You will hitting that particular person, or you will kicking them outside the room, or you will threatening them. I will kill you. I will shoot you. Golimara. Like that you will tell. That is called hostile aggression. Next one is relational aggression. Relational, relationship between friends or between family member. Fight between one brother and another brother. Fight between one sister and another sister for the cause of relationship. Sometimes for one boy, two girls will fight. For loving boy, two girls will fight. He is my boy. Sometimes boys will not fight for girl, but mostly I have seen girls fighting for one boy. I don't know, because girls' possession level is higher. Okay, so that type of aggression is called relational aggression. Now, let us see the characteristics of aggression, or now we will see the risk factors of aggression. So, first one is cluster B personality disorder. Bache, unmute. Sorry, mute. Mute karo, beta. Someone music is playing. Mute karo. Now, risk factors, cluster B personality disorder. So, personality disorder, three cluster we are dividing, cluster A, cluster B, cluster C. Cluster B may, what are the types of personality disorder coming? Histrionic personality disorder, narcissistic personality disorder, borderline personality disorder. So, those who have cluster B personalities will have aggression, violent behavior, jada. Okay, they are prone to jada, anger, aggression, behavior, jada. Next one is patient with cerebrovascular accident. Once they get recovered from the stroke, they show violent behavior more. Alzheimer disease, particularly old age people. So during the time of Alzheimer disease, they have disorientation. They have, they don't have proper memories. So they usually get violent, aggressive more. Next is patient with severe pain. When we cannot tolerate our pain, we show that emotional outburst in the way of anger and aggression. Patient with delirium, semi-conscious, during the semi-conscious stage in the delirium, disorientation of time, place, person, we show anger, aggression more. And some other psychotic disorders like mania, because of grandiose delusion, hyperactivity, they show anger and aggression. Major depressive. Yesterday we have seen the major depressive may, there is one phase. During that phase, they will have low mood and they will be psychomotor retardation. Once they come out of the phase, they will have more amount of energy. So because of excess amount of energy, what they will do, they will show violent aggressive behavior. And PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, these people also show anger and violent behavior. Last one is, that is risk factor, sensory deprivation, those who not hear properly, those who have visual deficit, those who have hearing deficit, they also show anger, aggression more. Okay. Now, let's see the characteristics of aggressive behavior. So, what are the characteristics of aggressive behavior? First one is, this violent behavior either show the violent activities either verbally or non-verbally. Second one is, violent behavior may invade personal space of others. They don't see the personal space of others. What they will do? They will do the what kind of things they will do means they will violate the personal space of others. They will violate the personal space of others. Next one is, they maintain eye-to-eye contact for long period. Depression patient does not maintain eye to eye contact, but this people maintain eye to eye contact jada time. Okay, these people maintain eye to eye contact very frequently. Okay, 1 minute. Next, we are seeing the gestures of violent people, how it will be threatening. They will not be friendly in nature. Their body language will be always showing some kind of threatening mannerisms. Okay, so the last characteristic is the posture. Always they will be erect like a bouncer, and they will be leaning forward when they speak with others. Like you can see the movie, how the villain is speaking with the hero, threatening, like the hero will be tied in the chair and the villain will be bending and threatening like that. Okay, so these are the characteristics of aggressive behavior. Now we want to see the management. Management is very, very important beta to write in the exam. So management, what are the things you want to keep in mind? First thing, let me explain very simply. So first, if you have any restraint, like if you have chained the patient, first you should remove that, because chaining, doing the restraint, that increases the violent aggressive behavior in the patient. Next one is always talk with the patient who is violent in a very firm and kind approach way. Don't order them, they will attack you. Okay, usually give sedation drug, make them to sleep. So what drug we usually give? Diazepam 10 to 20 milligram, or IV haloperidol 10 to 20 milligram, or chlorpromazine 50 to 100 milligram intramuscularly we give. So sedation effect, when they go for sleep, they get up very normal. The anger aggression comes down. Next one is, when once the patient is sedated, make any one relative to stay with the patient and make them to see whether they are sleeping normally or not. Okay. And we want to see the next management. What we want to do, Madhulab, regularly do the physical examination, mental status examination, and do lab investigation regularly to check whether any drug intoxication is present or not. And we want to see for, because we are keeping them in sedation for a long time, so during the time they can go for dehydration, malnutrition. So we want to give them adequate fluids and nutrition to in the management of aggression violence patient. Usually we give glucose saline drip, we used to give. Okay, next thing is, we must keep the room environment where the aggressive patient living very safe. Don't keep any sharp instruments in the living area of the patient. Don't keep the ropes, don't keep glass items, ties, strings, because they can do suicide or they can go for homicide. Okay, next important thing is about keep the environmental stimuli very low. Don't keep bright light. Don't play a sound music. Play mild music. Sometimes without music, silent environment is very good. Okay, limit the interaction with other. When the patient is alone, don't speak with others. That will definitely reduce the violent aggressive behavior. Okay. Now the next management is, when the patient becomes hyperactive, what you want to do, Madhulab? You must try to calm them, because when the patient becomes hyperactive, their anxiety level is also increasing. So you must calm them, you must reassure them, give support, psychological support, so they will come down. Okay, the emotional burst will reduce. Redirect violent behavior with the, for example, a patient is more aggressive, want to beat others. What you can do? You tell them, don't beat other. I will give you a pillow. You do boxing. You do all the physical aggressive behavior must be diverted towards the object, not towards a human being. If someone is anger, what we will tell if somebody is shouting, using verbal abuse, what you will tell? I will go from this place. You akele, आप बात करो, ऐसे हम बोल के हम जाना है ना, ऐसे पेशेंट को बोल दो अगर आप ज्यादा वाइग्रस एक्टिविटीज को इन्वॉल्व करना कैसे, क्या इन्वॉल्वमेंट, टेल देम टू प्ले कबड्डी गेम्स, टेल देम टू प्ले सम कुश्ती, टेल देम टू प्ले सम बास्केटबॉल, वॉलीबॉल, ओके, सो दैट फिजिकल अग्रेशन विल बी वेंटिलेटेड थ्रू सच एक्टिविटी. Next one is, if the patient is not calm, what we want to do, like we want to give the medicine, or you must tell that I will make you to go for put you in a separate room, so be calm, like that you give them some like threat, don't threatening, like you tell, see, if you are not cooperative, you will be separate, you cannot mingle with others, like that when you say, the anger aggression will reduce. Next thing is, we want to for example, this is very very important, if the person wants to attack you, the person wants to kill you, inke paas chaako hai, what you want to tell first, keep the chaako in the table, we will speak first, don't use chaako, it will be hurting others, or it may hurt you. So make a contract with the patient. When the patient obeys that, if the patient keeps the chaako in the table, what you want to do, you take the chaako without the patient knowledge, divert the patient in other activities, so such incidents, mishappenings will not happen in the psychiatric ward. Okay, so that is the thing. And the last important thing, we want to like this weapon I told you, na, sometimes with the help of pillow, with the help of mattress, or with the help of blanket, you put the blanket in the patient and you can control the patient, like if the patient is coming to kill someone, backside we want to go and we want to put the mattress or the pillow or what we can do, that blanket, and we pull them backside so that the violent behavior is kept in control. One person cannot do that, two or three people should confront the patient in different direction. By holding them, we can give the antipsychotic drugs like haloperidol, chlorpromazine, okay, diazepam, they will go for sleep, relaxation, okay. So these things we want to do. Finally, in the management, the medication, sometimes this secluding the patient with the help of restraints, that is not as advisable, because that is legal rights are not allowing, but sometimes we need to do, okay, but medication, chemical restraints, medication like antipsychotic drugs are very effective, okay. So exam in psychiatric emergency, what will come in the psychiatric emergency, what will come, either suicide will come, or violent aggressive behavior will come, or crisis intervention will come. So these three are major important questions. Tomorrow's video, what we can see, we will see the other psychiatric emergencies, okay. Now it is a time for discussion. If you have any doubt, please unmute your mic and you can ask one by one. बेटा अगर क्वेश्चन है मेरे से पूछो, टाइम बहुत कम है, एक और दो क्वेश्चन पूछो, किसी को डाउट नहीं है
सर,
प्लीज टेल योर नेम एंड आस्क योर क्वेश्चन, यूर बेटा दिस वीडियो वी आर रिकॉर्डिंग, एनी क्वेश्चन, समझ आ गया
सर, आई एम आस्किंग कि जो साइको पेशेंट्स होते हैं उनका एग्रेसिव बिहेवियर के लिए हमें सबसे पहले क्या करना चाहिए अगर हम प्रायोरिटी वाइज काम करें तो?
सबसे पहले यू वांट टू डू असेसमेंट, व्हाट व्हाई दिस अग्रेसिवनेस इज कमिंग, assessment only first step. When you do assessment, you can understand what is the risk factor, which is the precipitating factor. So after that, you first speak with the patient. If they are not obeying, then you try to control them either by chemical restraint or you by using some ropes. Okay, make them to sedate.
सर ऐसा कुछ होता है क्या जो एंटी माइग्रेन ड्रग्स होती हैं या फिर जो एंटी साइकोटिक ड्रग्स होती हैं उनकी वजह से हमारे ब्लड कलर जो है वो ग्रीन हो जाता है
ब्लड ग्रीन कैसे होता है बेटा कोई एविडेंस है
सर मैंने अभी पढ़ा था एक वो थी क्लिप थी एक कि जो लोग
व्हाट्सएप में शेयर करो व्हाट्सएप में शेयर करो मैं आई विल गो थ्रू दैट बिकॉज़ मेरे को अभी 12 साल एक्सपीरियंस है किसी मेरे को वो नहीं बताया अगर आप बताएंगे वो सही है मैं उसका पढ़ के मैं आपको क्लैरिफाई करूंगा
ओके सर आई विल शेयर यू
वेरी गुड और बेटा किसी को डाउट बेटा लास्ट वी आर हैविंग वेरी लेस टाइम प्लीज टेल योर अटेंडेंस प्लीज open your camera. We want to record your face for attendance purpose. I am seeing Vani the boss. Please open your camera so that we can know who are all attending the lectures, beta. I am seeing that Sakshi Paul photo only. I am seeing. Please open your camera for attendance purpose, beta. Varsha, please open your camera, beta, for attendance purpose. Only I am seeing this Varsha. I am seeing. What about Akansha, Sakshi, Jangra, Akan? Please open, beta. Just a minute. For attendance purpose, Yashwant, I am seeing. I don't know the name. Just everything we are recording. Again, I will send you the video in the YouTube. If you have other teacher also seeing you. So I hope you all enjoyed the class. Any doubt? Okay, beta. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed. Tomorrow we will see the other topics. Okay? Take care, beta. Bye. Kahan sir? Okay, bye-bye.